Pilots, Drain Man here, and today I have got a very special video. In today's video, we're going to be checking out the all new, brand new, hot off the press Speedy B F7 Mini Stack. And there ain't nothing mini about this guy. Well, the size. But other than the size, there is nothing mini about this stack. This stack pays mine to all the guys who want to run their 2 to 4 inch quadcopters. And hell, if you want to run a full size quadcopter and you just want a small stack on it, maybe you need the space. I don't know. Maybe you're a racer and you're trying to shave weight. Doesn't matter. This guy is going to be for you. Let's go. Alright, pilots, I am excited because it's not every day that you see such a small formed flight controller ESC combo with so many features on it. So let's go ahead and crack this puppy open. It comes in a nice Speedy B box. If you wiggle her open, right on top, you'll have a link to your manual, and we'll go over that here in a minute. I want to first dive in and see what we got, what all comes with it. If we pop out this foam, which is nice to see that it's packaged nice and tight and protected, you've got your flight controller right here on top and your ESC right here on the bottom. Pop this guy out. And there you go. You've got both right there. What a beautiful color choice. We've got a navy blue with yellow grommets. I absolutely love it. All right, so inside, you've got what looks to be accessories. Let's go ahead and pop this out. Okay, so you've got a baggie here with a XT30. You've got your jumper, which is going to get you from your flight controller to your ESC. Plug and play, baby. But all flight controller ESC combos these days have this type of jumper, which means you're going to have all your motors, power, ground, and even telemetry already set up, ready to go. Very nice. Now, you get yourself a capacitor. This is a low ESR electrolytic capacitor. It is a 470 35 volt. Now, why is it a 35 volt if this is a micro? Aha. Because this guy here runs all the way from 3 to 6S LiPos. It is a 35 amp ESC, so feel free to run it on your big guy. You're not going to have any issues there. If you do that, you're welcome to run XT30 or change her out for an XT60. Who cares? All right. Oh, look at that. That gives it away. What does that say? That says M3. Oh, yeah. If I flip this over, what does that say? Oh, yeah. M2. What does that mean? You can run M2 or M3 on this little guy, and that's pretty awesome. And they hooked you up with everything that you need to do so. Well, and they labeled it for you too. So inside of here, you've got all your bolts, nuts, grommets, washers, plastic, or aka nylon nuts. They're not lock nuts, but they are nuts, which gives you what you need. You can mount this guy and put it in a micro quad or in a full size quad. All right, in this bag here, you've got all the grommets you need. Now, why does the M3 bag have grommets and the M2 bag does not? Well, that's because the stack already has the M2s on it for you. So if you decide that that's what you want to run, go ahead and pull those out, pop those yellow guys in, and run away with M3. Well, look how tiny. I mean, they're just so tiny. Here's a regular size flight controller. Look at that. I mean, it puts it to shame. Look, I'm gonna hide it from you. What stack? All right, so let's take a quick look over this flight controller. We're just gonna take a quick little peeky peek at the specs. You are running an STM32F722 microcontroller right there. There she is in all of its glory. And then you've got a MPU 6000 gyro. We are running the USB-C connector. That is awful, awful nice. You're also packing right here. This is your Betaflight OSD chip on board. You've got your BLE Bluetooth. If you're not sure what that is Bluetooth Low Energy. energy. It's basically just a very low energy pulling type of Bluetooth. Normal Bluetooth would draw a ton of power. This guy is not going to draw much power at all. You won't even know it's there. Plus, it's very, very small. You can pretty much put it on anything. It's what's inside of your cell phones, all that kind of stuff. All right, you've also got Wi-Fi inside of here, which is used on the same BLE chip. Got HD capable. That means there is a 9-volt BEC on board. So that means on this board, you can wire up your DJI Air unit. I mean, Caddx Vista or DJI Air Unit Lite, you can put that on anything due to it being able to handle 6S. But this guy accommodates the OG Air Unit if that's what you have, seeing that it tops out at like 16 or 17 volts. So you've got a 9-volt BEC on board. It does go up to 2 amps, so it can easily handle all the current that you have to deliver. All right, ESC signal pads, 1 through 4. Obviously, you need 4 motors to run a quadcopter. You've got 3 full UARTs. You've got 1, 2, and 3 that are all available right here on this guy. You've got 6 groups of 5-volt output. So that gives you your 5-volt pads, and then you've also got a buzzer pad, which does your buzzer if you want to run a buzzer. Continuing on, you have another full UART, which is UART 4, but you can't really utilize that because you're going to be using it for your ESC telemetry. All right, what else do we have? We've also got a boot button right here. Looky here. Very, very nice. Okay. You are able to run SmartPort. I don't know how many guys are still running FR Sky and still using the SmartPort feature, but you do have that on board ready to go. Being that it's Betaflight, you got Betaflight options, Emu Flight options, and this guy also does iNav for the guys running it. It's got its own target inside of Betaflight. Now, it is 20 by 20 mounting. I don't think I have to tell you that because you see the size and it's so mini, but guess what? It's 20 by 20 mounting, just in case you didn't know. You're running Beehawley S. You've got 35 amp ESC right here. Now, when I say 35 amp ESC, I don't mean the whole thing's 35 amps. I mean that it's 35 amps per channel. So 35 times 4. But you would just say it's a 35 amp ESC. Okay, it can handle full VBAT write-up given from the ESC. So if anything happens to this ESC, you don't want to run it, you want to run a big one, you want a better one, you want a faster one, a stronger one, slower one, whatever, you can still hook this guy up to full LiPo voltage and just run it, love it, enjoy it, okay? All right, all up weight, we're looking at about 7 grams for our ESC and about 5.7 grams for our flight controller. Most people don't care about that stuff, but when we're getting into something of this size, we are talking about having and not losing any of our features, not losing any of our specs, any of our power. We are actually gaining a shun-ton of freaking features, but we are also shaving weight. Because why? If you're a racer and you wanna go fast. All right, so you've got a full WS2812, which is the regular addressable LED pad available on here if you want to run it. All right, so also real quick, it does not support RSSI. Not a big deal, but if it matters to you, it doesn't have it. Also, no barrow. There is no barometer. So if you want to run that, you are going to have to find another solution. And last but not least, you do have current sensing on this guy. It's built right here on the ESC, and you can see it right here. Okay? All right. So there's a couple more things I want to go over. But before we do, who wants to look in the scope? All right, guys, let's take a quick look at the ESC. And what is truly awesome about Speedy Bee is right there in their own laboratory, they pretty much do like I do, and they do a ESC torture test, if you will. I mean, obviously it's not that, it's probably something a little more technical, but they take the ESCs, they strap them to a quad, they strap them in, they put a power supply, and they gun it. And they push these ESCs hard. They find out, they make sure that if they're writing on there that it's a 35 amp ESC, that they have ran it at 45, 50 amps. Taking a quick look, right there's your current sensing. We talked about this already. You've got it on board. There it is. You've got your microcontrollers and MOSFETs all around the sides. On the back, we can see that we've got our filtration right here looking good. 35 amp mini BL Heli S Speedy B ESC. Very, very nice. MOSFETs and the works. We're looking good. All right. Now, you do have motor pads and XT60 or XT30 with the capacitor holes, which we like. You've got that on both sides and on the sides itself. Mm-hmm. Some guys like to take their wires, throw it up against the side, slap a bead of solder on it, and call it a day. So there's your ESC looking good. Let's go ahead and take a quick peek at the flight controller, and all right, so this is a mini little guy. I can almost fit the whole flight controller right inside of the scope view, which is pretty freaking awesome here. All right, so let's take a quick look at what we got on board. All right, so up here in the top, right here, that is your 8 megabytes of flash on board, which is accessible through the app on your phone. Very nice. You've got your Betaflight OSD chip right here. So although this can run DJI, you can still run Analog 2 and get full Betaflight OSD. All right, so right here, this little guy right here, this is your BLE chip. And BLE devices are discovered through the broadcasting of advertising packets over 3 separate frequencies to reduce interference. This is pretty awesome. It's just a new way that they're handling Bluetooth and saving energy and getting the job done at affordable a price. The fact that they can get this stacked to you with all the features it has, plus Bluetooth, plus Wi-Fi, plus this, plus that, for the price that it is. So right here, you're going to notice your 3.3 volt regulator. That's this guy right here. Right next to that, we've got our MPU6000. It is an Invisense, which is a very popular brand. Very simple. You've got your analog stuff. So this is going to take everything from your analog camera to your analog VTX. Down here at the bottom, you've got your LEDs, 5-volt ground LED. That's going to be your signal. Then you've got what you can run down here for all of your receivers, everything from Crossfire to FR Sky, everything you want and need. You've got some spare UARTs right over in this area. Right down here, we've got everything that you need to run your DJI. If you're going to run the radio, if you're going to run an air unit light, if you're going to run a full-size OG air unit, doesn't matter. You've got everything you need right here with your 9-volt pad for power. You've got your ground. You've got your full UART, which is TX2, RX2. Then you've got a ground because you need that for your signal if you're running your radio. And then you're going to wire your S-Bus right here to R1. All right, so moving right along, if we flip this guy over right here on the back, you're going to notice that we've got a switching regulator up here, and we've got another circuit right here, and that's pretty much going to be your 9-volt and 5-volt switching regulators that are on board, which is allowing you to run all the things that you want to run, everything from analog cameras to LEDs, buzzers, you name it, it does it, and DJI too. All right, so last up on the chopping block is our microcontroller, and that's this guy right here. It is a very nice STM32F722 chip. Beautiful chip, plenty of speed, plenty of UARTs. It does the job and does it well. All right, pilot, so one thing I want to show you real quick. If you go to your package inside, you're going to have this little jumper right here, and you've only got one plug on this guy, so there's no need to be confused. I will go ahead and plug that in. Beautiful snug fit. And then I'll go ahead and take my ESC and I will plug that in, okay, just like that. And then what we're going to do is we are going to grab this little yellow paper that came with your SpeedyBee stack, and it serves multiple purposes. It's got your manual on it, but also if you don't know where to find the app or you don't know how to get the app, I'm going to show you right now. Go ahead and open up your phone and then pull out your camera. That's what I've got here. And you're going to notice, look, right away already, it's only got a little glimpse and it's already telling me that it's found it. So let me show you. I got to probably move this up and put that on there. And what do we got? Move back to improve focus. Look at that. It pops up just like that. So whether you've got Apple, Android, doesn't matter. Put your camera. This is just my camera. This is not a QR code reader, blah, blah, blah. I literally just went to my camera. All right, so now I'm going to click that, and it's going to bring me right here to their website where you can get your manual, and you can also get your SpeedyBee app. So I'll click here. This will take me to the Play Store. And right from here, we can go ahead and download this app. Boom, just like that. It's going to download and do its thing. And then from there, we will be ready to go ahead and control our flight controller, which, I mean, really, does it get any better than that? All right, and once it's done downloading, you'll see that it's right here ready to go. I'll just go ahead and click open, and boom, it will bring me right into the app, and then I can go ahead and get rocking and rolling. So here's what we need to do. Try this app in demo mode. We can go Wi-Fi, we can go Bluetooth, or we can connect via USB. Taking a look at the app, how cool is that? I am fully connected. Look, my gyro is responding to the movement of the flight controller. So how cool is that? And even right from here on that first menu, you saw the Wi-Fi. You can connect to Wi-Fi and you can go ahead and flash this guy. We can get into the black box logs. We can do it all. This flight controller is super awesome. It is super mini and it packs a super awesome punch. I hope that you guys learned something. I hope that you guys want to minimize your life and get yourself a nice SpeedyBee F7 Mini. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you on the next one.